Hey guys, this is AV. Today we will learn how to create a PDF in React using the react-pdf/renderer library. The library has a total of 12 direct dependencies that are used by it. To begin, we first need to install the package using the command npm install at react-pdf/renderer save. And here are the other ways. If you want to install this library using other tools like yarn, pnpm, and bun, you can. Additionally, it's compatible with node.js and next.js. For next.js, you'll need to update the config.js file. It's also compatible with ESBuild. So this is basically how the architecture of this React PDF renderer works initially. It tries to create internal structures using React documents, resolves styles using assets and text, wraps everything inside pages, and then renders it on the front end. We'll focus on discussing this for React only. First of all, we will import the document and all the required tags from the React PDF library. Then we will use the document component like this. Import document from @react-pdf/renderer. This creates the React PDF component, which will be the main component we focus on. The complete PDF will be wrapped inside this component, treating each separate document as a separate PDF. This component can be used in multiple ways, such as providing a download link for the PDF, showcasing the PDF, or getting components or the blob component from the PDF itself. Let's first understand the creation of a React PDF as a document component. Then we will understand its use case. The document component has many props, all of which are easy to understand. For example, props like title, author, subject, keywords, creator, producer, PDF version, and language only require strings and can be any as per the requirement. Now these three props are more complicated: page mode, page layout, and on render propane. Page mode accepts page mode types, which could be any of the following: none. Neither document bookmarks nor thumbnail images would be visible. It would be just the basic PDF. Use outlines. Document bookmarks are visible. Use thumbs. Thumbnail images are visible. Use full screen. Full screen mode would be there with no menu bar, window controls, or any other window visible. Use OC, optional content group visible panel. Use attachments, attachments panel visible. For example, if you are attaching any child PDF inside it or any link provided to the document inside the PDF. Similarly, the same applies to the page layout prop. You can use any of these values, which are simple to understand. It determines the layout of the page displayed in the PDF viewer or after downloading the PDF. The last prop for the document component is onRender, which is a callback function triggered after the PDF is completely rendered. For example, let's say we have a dummy callback function named testRender, inside which we simply print the output of the document after rendering is completed. Here is an example of the output of the callback function post the document is rendered, which includes the blob as well as the complete React component layout as a document object in JSON format. Now, let's focus on the page component. The page component represents a different page of the PDF inside the document. These are the props of the page component, which are also easy to understand. Size. You can specify the size of the page, such as A4, A3, or any custom number for width and height. Orientation. You can set either portrait or landscape orientation. Wrap. This element wraps the content if the text goes beyond the bounds or width automatically. Style, used for providing styling to the page. Debug, enables debugging mode, showing exact margins, padding, and pixel usage for the page. DPI, increasing DPI improves PDF quality, but also increases PDF size. ID, provides the destination ID to be linked inside the link component. I will explain this properly. Bookmark, provides the bookmark element to the PDF. This is how you use the page component and its props. For example, the size prop determines the size of the page, while the orientation prop can be set to either landscape or portrait. Let's see the difference in how these modes look. In the portrait mode with debugging enabled, you can see how it looks in the PDF viewer and how it will appear when you download the PDF. On the third page, I also included the bookmark prop, which would look something like this when viewing the PDF. Next, let's discuss the subcomponents of the page component. The view component has these props, which are also straightforward. Wrap, a Boolean property used to wrap the content inside the view component. Style, custom styling can be provided here. Render, a function that enables rendering dynamic content inside the PDF. This dynamic content is not from external sources like APIs, but from the react-pdf library itself. I'll show you how this works. Fixed. This component ensures that the content remains fixed, regardless of the components or sizes given. ID, used to provide the destination ID for linking. Bookmark, similar to the one in the page component, clicking on a bookmark will navigate to that specific view component, page component, or subcomponents where the bookmark is placed. For example, I've applied a styling sheet and used it inside this view component. The render prop, similar to the one used in the text component, allows you to include dynamic content from the PDF itself, such as page number, total pages, subpage number, subtotal, and subpage total. You can use these dynamic content elements inside the render prop of the view component as well. Let's move on to the image component, which has props like src and source, both of which are similar. You can use either one by default. Additionally, you can use the style prop and enable debug mode here as well. The fixed prop works the same way as explained earlier. The cache prop allows you to cache the image, which is helpful during consecutive image rendering in your app. The bookmark prop is similar to others. The source prop for the image component should have one of these five values: a string directly representing the URL, a URL object containing the valid URI, method, header, and body. This is useful for images requiring authentication, as you can include all necessary details in the URL object. A buffer, which automatically detects the image format, PNG or JPG, without needing the image extension. A data buffer, to create an object of data and define the possible format of that buffer image. Your custom callback function, ideally returning either the URL of the image or the base 64 image string. This is how you implement the image component, and this is how it appears in the PDF. Next is the link component, which has the source prop. You can directly use the link to a domain or IP, or you can provide a link within the PDF itself to jump to a particular section. It also has props like style, debug, fixed, and bookmark, which are similar to others. The link component implementation involves specifying the source tech with a particular ID to enable internal jumps within the PDF. We use a hashtag before the ID, and then we use the same ID in the subcomponent where we want to jump to. Clicking on this section directly jumps to that particular section of the PDF. Finally, the note component has props like style and children. In children, you can use either the text component or any string component. The fixed prop is also used similarly to others. This is how the note component looks when implemented as fixed in the PDF. Next, let's discuss the canvas component, which has similar props such as style, debug, fixed, and bookmark as the others. The distinct component here is the paint component, which uses the painter function. When defining the canvas, it's crucial to specify the width and height inside the style prop, so that react-pdf knows the space the drawing occupies in the canvas. The painter function used inside paint has three parameters: the painter object, available width, and available height. To learn more about the allowed methods in the Painter object, you can refer to the PDF Kit documentation, or let me know if you want a separate video walkthrough on PDF Kit. Moving on to the PDF Viewer, PDF Download Link, and Blob Provider components, these are not part of the PDF component itself. These components include the complete document component within them, but are not part of the document component. In the PDF Viewer component, we have props like style, class name, children, similar to the document component, and the total height and width of the PDF viewer shown in the browser. The toolbar is shown by default, but you can turn it off if needed. The implementation of the PDF viewer component includes enabling the toolbar, specifying the width and height in the style prop, and passing the document component as a child, which we've created separately. Finally, the PDF download link component has props similar to the document component, including document, file name, class name, and children. These work the same way as in the PDF viewer component. The implementation of the PDF download link component involves providing the document and specifying the desired file name for saving. Within the children prop, we define a callback function that includes all four components: blob, URL, loading, and error. The blob component returns the blob data, URL returns the document's URL, and error handles any issues, such as incorrect format or creation problems, with the document component in React. Moving on, we have the blob provider component, which simplifies accessing blob data without displaying it on the screen. This component has two props: document and children. The children prop includes the same callback function with blob, URL, error, and loading states as arguments, mirroring the PDF download link component's functionality. While React PDF supports SVG images, it's generally recommended to create SVGs using dedicated tools like Adobe Illustrator or Photoshop instead of creating them from scratch within the library. However, if necessary, you can still create SVG images directly in React PDF. There's also a hook available in this library called useapdf, which directly updates the rendered PDF document without repeatedly reloading it. This hook returns props like URL, blob, loading, and error. Let's explore how we've implemented this in our code. In our implementation, we provide our document component inside the useapdf hook. We then check if the instance is in a loading or error state. Based on this, we either return our custom React output or simply provide the link for users to download the PDF. This hook allows dynamic updates to the PDF viewer as the PDF component updates, or you can use it to update the blob data in the blob viewer. Regarding styling in the React PDF library, it's quite standard and similar to basic styling in regular React code. This includes using media queries and various CSS properties. However, you can refer to the documentation for more details. Similarly, using fonts is straightforward. We import the font component from the React PDF library and register the fonts we need to use. This includes specifying the font source, family, styling, weight, and even a hyphenation callback for scenarios where string modifications are required. For example, we can use the hyphenation callback to replace vowels with hyphens as needed. Additionally, if you want to include images, you can use the register_emojis source method to implement this functionality. React PDF also provides a Node API for directly rendering files on the backend. This allows you to generate the PDF file in the backend and then provide the backend file path to the user as a download link or to view it in the front end. However, in this discussion, we are primarily focusing on the React part of using the library. Some advanced features of React PDF that we've discussed include page wrapping, document navigation for jumping to specific sections within the PDF, bookmarks, on-the-fly rendering with loading status, and accessing block data. We've also seen how to use the useapdf hook for managing PDF content dynamically, along with rendering props for customizing content display. Additionally, we explored debugging options for adjusting padding, margins, and content spacing, as well as hyphenation for string modifications. This tutorial covers almost all major real-world use cases and properties of the React PDF library. However, there are additional properties available that you can explore further in the documentation. If you found this information helpful, please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing. Thank you for watching.